Okay, hi everyone. My name is Manasi Navare, and I work at Intel on the i915 graphics kernel driver team. So today I want to talk about this feature, display stream compression, which I've been working on for the past few months. So talking about display, what kind of display resolution do you prefer? So 2K, you know, kind of history now. It was really cool back in the days. But moving on, now probably most of us have 4K displays, monitors, or even the laptop panels. So the trend is, you know, bigger screens, higher resolution. So what next, right? 5K and probably higher. So let's see if the display port bandwidth, you know, has been able to keep up with these advancements in the resolution. So the first display port spec, the DP1.1 spec, only supported reduced bitrate or NHBR, which could do 2.7 gigabits per second per lane. So that was able to do 2K at 60 hertz. The next one was DP1.2 spec, which added a new rate, HBR2, and that could do 5.4 gigabits per second per lane. So total using four lanes, it could do 21.6 gigabits per second. So it could do 4K at 60. So the latest spec, DP1.4, adds a higher bitrate, HBR3, and it can do 8.1 gigabits per second per lane. And so can it do like 5K, you know, at higher frame rates and even higher resolutions? Let's see how that translates to the, you know, numbers and the math. So let's consider a 5K frame. So just one frame, it's almost 15 million pixels just in one frame. And then when you have, you know, start streaming it at higher frame rates, let's say 120 frames per second, it adds up pretty fast. And then you have 1769 million pixels per second. That's a lot of data. So 1769 million pixels per second. And then if we just consider basic RGB pixel, 24 bits per pixel, and then it adds really fast to give 42.4 gazillion bits per second. So that's like tremendous amount of data you want to transmit over the display port cable. So let's see if we actually have the goods to, you know, view at that rate, right? So we just saw that the required display bandwidth for like high resolution, high frame rate is 42.4 gigabits per second. And what we have with the latest DP standard at HBR3 is only 32.4 gigabits per second. So what do I do? And that's where the new standard comes into picture. VESA introduced the display stream compression. It's an industry-wide standard for visually lossless compression. Data-wise, it is lossy, but then the spec says that it is, they have done, you know, experiments to make sure that the user cannot distinguish between whether the compression is active or not. It's supported on EDP 1.4, DP 1.4, and the MIPDSI standards. It supports all the common video formats, and it's supposed to have a constant compression rate, compression ratio guarantee, irrespective of the data. And we have enabled it on Gen 11, so Ice Lake platform, starting Ice Lake platforms. So basically 24 bits per pixel, we can compress it up to 3x to give just 8 bits per pixel. So what that means in terms of bandwidth is requested is 42.4, we compress it, we get 14 gigabits per second, and now it can fit in the available display port bandwidth. So quick overview of the encoding process. You start with a frame that gets divided into independently decoded segments called slices. So one slice is nothing but groups of pixels, and then each group is three or six consecutive pixels. So you operate on the group of pixels, and it goes through a very convoluted encoding process where it does block prediction, quantization, and the residual error then gets entropy encoded to give the variable length coding, to generate the variable length coded bitstream, and then you combine the bitstreams from all these groups to give the multiplex substream. And then finally, what you need at the output is a constant bitrate, so you pass it through the rate buffer and you get the constant bitrate output. If you want to learn more about it, it's like a 5,000-page spec, which talks, you know, with all the details of the encoding process and how it's proven to be visually lossless. So how do we, enable a display stream compression on our graphics pipeline? Start with the, you know, the 5K frame buffer scanout. It goes to the CRTC on the display controller, and that's where we compute the all the display stream compression parameters in the atomic check phase. So that's where we make sure that, you know, the requested mode and the requested compression ratio can be supported, and the hardware is able to actually compress the requested frame. So at that point, it's still uncompressed pixel data. It goes to the DSC encoder, which sits on the pipe. And then after everything is computed, it computes the PPS, which is the picture parameter set, which is the set of the parameters that are required on the source side as well as on the sync side to decompress the frame. It gets committed on the atomic commit, and then you send it across over the display port cable. On the other end, the DSC decoder sitting inside the EDP panel or the monitor gets the encoding parameters from the source device, and then it uses that for decoding, and you get the uncompressed display. So this is just a summary of how it's implemented across the DRM and I915. Because most of the parts of this implementation are DSC spec related, it's common set of helpers that parse the DSC DPCD registers and get all the display stream compression parameters, and also to form the encoding parameters that need to be sent on the sync side. So all that is sitting in the DRM layer, so that can be shared across all the other vendor specific drivers. And then we have I915 hardware specific implementation and enabling the actual hardware pipeline details in I915. There are IGT tests, which I'm still working on. It's not submitted to the mailing list, but basically that's going to enable the DSC with different combinations of the input color depth and the output compressed bits per pixel. So I need your help for reviewing the patches. It's on the mailing list, both the DRM implementation as well as the I915 implementation. So one of the challenges with DSC for higher resolutions is that, because of the hardware limitations, so the VDSC engine, which is on every pipe, can only operate at 1 pixel per clock. So for higher resolutions and higher frame rates, if the pixel clock is greater than the CD clock, then at that point you need to split the frame across two pipes. And for example, in case of 5K at 120 hertz, the pixel clock is going to be 2500 megahertz, which is way higher than the CD clock that we support on the platform. So in that case, we do have some of the design opens and possible changes in the kernel and user space interface. How do we split the frames across two pipes? So option one is, the user space only sees it as one mode, so it just does one mode set, and then the kernel internally forms two CRTC states from that single CRTC state and then sends it across two pipes. But that means we are hiding the second pipe from the user space, which is not good, because user space is only going to see, if it's three pipes, then it's probably only going to see two pipes. And then also that would require major refactoring in the atomic code within DRM and I915, because we would have to maintain two CRTC states internally per pipe. Option two is for the kernel to fake the display as a tiled display. So even if it's one single 5K frame, then kernel basically fakes the EDID information to say that it's a tiled display, and that way user space sees it as, two modes, tries to do two separate mode sets, and that way we have the two CRTCs exposed to the user space. But again, there are some challenges there because of the fake EDID, and I guess I'm trying to get inputs on these changes, and there will be more discussions happening on, Intel Graphics and DRI Devil mailing list regarding this. And if you have any ideas, suggestions, please let's talk on IRC and the mailing list. Thank you.